So students, let's do another question on lines and angles. I'll read out the question for you. In this figure, we have given lines AB and CD. They are intersecting at point O. This is the line AB and this is the line CD and this is the point of intersection, that is O, right? What is the data that is given to us? Angle AOC plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degree. Now what is AOC? Angle AOC, right? And this is angle BOE. The sum of these two angles is equal to 70 degree. And angle BOD, this is angle BOD, this is given to be 40 degrees. Now what do we need to find is, we have to find angle BOE and angle COE, right? So I have drawn the diagram for you, and whenever you come across this question of lines and angles, always make sure that it is easy to deal with angles which are marked as 1, 2, 3 and 4, rather angle COE, AOB, like that, right? So whenever the question comes, mark the angles. I have marked angle AOC, angle AOC as angle 1. I have marked angle COE as angle 3, angle BOE as angle 2, angle AOD as angle 4, and angle BOD, which is given to us as 40 degrees. So I have not marked this angle, right? So what do we need to find? We have to find angle BOE. Where is BOE? This is BOE. We have to find this angle, that is angle 2, right? And the next is angle COE. Where is COE? COE this, we have to find angle 3. So these are the two unknown angles that we need to find. So the data that is given to us is angle AOC plus angle BOE is 70 degree, right? Now what is angle AOC? That is angle 1 plus BOE, which is unknown to us, angle 2 is 70 degrees, right? And angle BOD is equal to 40 degrees, right? As I can see that AOB, it forms a straight line, right? And OC and OE, they are rays lying on the straight line. So angle 1, 3, 2, they'll form a linear triplet, or I can say AOB is a straight line. Right? And OC is a ray. Right? So I can say that angle AOC plus angle COE will be equal to 180 degree. Why it will be equal to 180 degree? Because I have learned the property that sum of linear pair of angles is equal to 180 degree, and angle AOC and COE, they form a linear pair, right? So angle AOC, I'll write it as angle 1, and I'll write angle COE. Now COE, I'll write it as angle 3. Now this is not COE, this is COB. I'm sorry, this is angle COB. This is equal to 180 degree, right? So COB can be written as angle 3 plus angle 2. Angle 3 plus angle 2, that is equal to angle COB. This is equal to 180 degree, right? Now 1 plus 2 is equal to 70 degree. Substituting the value 1 plus 2 here, I get 70 degree plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. So angle 3 comes out to be 180 degree minus 70, that is equal to 110 degrees, right? So we got the value of angle 3, that was angle COE, that is known to us, that is 110 degrees, right? Now what do we need to do? We have to find angle BOE, right? So what we can do next? We can write angle 3, 1 and 2, they form a linear pair, so their sum is equal to 180 degree, right? And then we substituted the value of angle 1 plus 2, which was equal to 70 degree here. Then we got the value of angle 3, which is equal to 110 degree, right? Now let me rub this. Now let's look at another straight line. COD is a straight line. With, I'll say, OB as the ray, OB as the ray. So I can say that angle C, angle COE plus angle EOD is equal to 180 degree. How come 180 degree? Because they are also forming a linear pair, right? And I can write angle COE as 110 degrees. 110. If you are considering OB as the ray, then we'll write COB. This will be COB and BOD. Sorry, the ray was OB. OB is the ray, so angle COB plus angle BOD would be 180 degree. Now I can write COB as, angle COB can be written as angle COE plus angle EOB, right? I have written angle COB as angle COE plus angle EOB, COE and EOB, right? Now COE is equal to 110 degrees. So 110 degrees, BOD is equal to 40 degrees, BOD is equal to 40 degrees, right? So angle EOB would be, solving it, 110 plus 40, that is 150. So angle EOB would be 180 degrees minus 150 degrees, that is equal to 30 degrees. So angle BOE or EOB comes out to be 30 degrees, right? So we got the two angles, angle 3 is 110 and angle 2 is 30 degrees, right? Let's look at another question. Right? Now let me draw the figure for you. This is AB, O, this angle is called W, this have Z, this is Y, this is X. Fortunately, they have already marked the angles for X for us as X, Y, W and Z. Now, they have given that X plus Y is equal to W plus Z. This is given to us. X plus Y, that is this, is equal to W plus Z, right? Now we have to prove that AOB is a line. What is to prove? AOB is a line, right? X plus Y is equal to W plus Z, right? So as we can see that the sum of all the angles around the point, the sum of all the angles around the point, as we did in a previous example, X plus Y plus W plus Z is 360. Sum of all the angles, sum of all angles around a point is 360 degrees, right? We already solved a question on this concept, right? So the sum is 360 degrees and we know that X plus Y is equal to W plus Z. So I can simply write X plus Y, I can write W plus Z as X plus Y only from this equation which is given to us. So this becomes 2X plus Y is equal to 360 degrees and X plus Y becomes 360 divided by 2, that is 180 degrees. Now, as we know that if the adjacent angles, they lie on a straight line, then their sum is 180 degree. This was the first axiom. Now, what was the converse of this axiom? If the sum of adjacent angles is equal to 180 degree, then the line is a straight line. Here we have X and Y, they are adjacent angles. What are they? Adjacent angles. Adjacent angles and their sum is 180 degree. So by axiom 2, AOB would be a straight line, right? This implies AOB is a straight line, Why? Because when the sum of adjacent angles is equal to 180 degree, that is, they form a linear pair, then the AOB would form a straight line, or the line due to the non-common arms would form a straight line, right? So this question is also solved.